A new project out in the shop. This is a Fujitsu split unit air conditioner. It's actually a heat pump. This will cool and heat. And this is about the same size as my two small window air conditioners that are out here in the shop. It's located between the bandsaw and my miter saw. So the potential for this to get clogged up with dust is fairly great. It takes air in through coils back here in the back, all along the front, and down here. I removed the shroud to see what I was working with here. And the piece that goes down across the front here, my initial thoughts are I'm going to take this off and leave it off, because all this is restriction to airflow. I want to accomplish two things. I want to box this in and capture an air volume that will go through a filter. And removing the air restriction here, as I see it, I'm replacing the air restriction with putting this filter in here. Then the air goes through the coils and it comes out here. And these units are usually mounted much higher up in the room of a house or an apartment, and they have these motorized fins on here that sweep back and forth to sweep the air up and down. I have removed those. I don't want that. The last thing I want is cold air blowing on me. So I'm going to change this duct, the air coming in through a filter, and I'm going to blow this up towards the ceiling. We'll see how that works. And at the same time, I need to stay out of the way of this thing so that I can change the blades on the bandsaw. I changed my mind and decided to mount this higher. It's almost 2 foot higher, not quite. Raising that higher will further decrease the chance of dust getting into that immediately. And filter should stay cleaner longer. And the air that I have to deflect from here, I don't have to deflect it as much to get it to go to the center of the ceiling. The filter holder is just being held up here with a couple of clamps, and this piece rests on an angled plastic as part of the shroud. It's just held in place with a couple of pieces of tape. I've placed these sticks in here. These are leftover pieces from when I cut all the wood to make the filter holder. They're glued in place. I'm going to put a diagonal on here and take this down, put a piece of plywood on here. It's a little bit difficult to match all this up with the unit hanging on the wall. This thing's about 7.5, 8 foot in the air. This is boxed in and the two sides are enclosed. And these sides make positive contact with the sides of the air handler, so that's pretty well sealed. So all airflow will be going through the filter. The filter frame ends up on top. We've got this part and both sides are enclosed with, that's just 1/8 inch bolted birch plywood. Look inside. These are just butt glued in here and let the glue dry. And once that plywood is on there, this is quite solid. I don't have any filters for this yet. We'll just use the ones from my shop air filter. And the filters just slide in there. These are 8 MERV rating filters, which are supposed to be good for dust, lint, dander, pollen, mold spores, and bacteria. That sounds good enough to me. Surely I don't have all that here in the shop. These filters are wire-backed, supported, and I just keep reusing these. I go outside with the air compressor and I blow the dust out of them, and that's plenty good. I've been reusing these again and again for several years on my window unit air conditioners, and they've proven to be quite adequate. Cold air comes out along here. I've created this ductwork coming around the corner. Bulkhead's in place. Another piece of plywood will go here. Then I need need a hinge mechanism that will allow this to swing down so I can clean the filters. This is completed. I put a plexiglass window in here because there are no manual controls on this unit. It's all by infrared remote. The infrared has to see that little square white part in the center, and then there's indicator lights on either side that show if it's responding to the controls. If you want to clean the filters, pull this down. I have this stop on here to rest on the bandsaw, just so it doesn't pinch this drain hose over here. And it's very easy to get to the filters. And when you're done, just put it back up. There's a catch over here. It pretty much stays there by itself. This catch is an added safety feature. You don't want that thing to fall down and hit you in the head. This top part is hinged on a wood dowel on each side, and that dowel is attached to this disc. Remove these two screws, pull this out, and it releases this hinge bracket. And this is gravity operated. Let's bring it down. Your supply and return lines from the compressor power come out here and go to the outside unit. This air conditioner has these plastic mesh screens. Same thing as what's in the window air conditioners, and that will stop bugs, airborne lint. These units are usually mounted pretty high in the ceiling, so they're not really intended to stop very much. I've seen shows like this little house and say that that's good enough to stop the dust in a carpenter shop, and I can guarantee you that's not the case. I put them in there as a secondary filter, just in case something gets past these. I added another deflection here, an additional 22 degrees to get this air out away from the lights on my ceiling and to help prevent cold air from cavitating back into the filters. The line set and power cable was installed, the drain line. Line set continues around, goes behind my TV, and goes out through the wall. This unit is 110 volts. The compressor outside will plug in here, and then the compressor feeds power back to the indoor air handler. I used some of these brackets to clamp around my dust collection pipe so I didn't have to put any screws in here. Brought a bracket down here to support the drain line. I cut some chain links out, bolted them on both sides, and there's just a tie strap on there. Keeps that. This rests flat on top of this clamp, and it's not going to get bounced out of there by accident. I put a T in the drain line, and the cap up there is just sitting on there. It's a loose fit. And if this line gets filled with a bunch of mold and slime and stuff, I can put a cork outside. Plug the line, fill this with a little bit of bleach solution, let it sit there for a couple of hours, flush it out, and it's good to go. This unit's running, you can barely hear it. The infrared remote works through that plexiglass window. This is equivalent to both of my window AC units. It's much quieter, and I hope I can shoot video without turning it off. I had to shut off the window units because they were so noisy. Not everything works the way you expect it to. Originally, I had two filters up here. When I started running the unit, it cooled the shop quite well, but it did not dehumidify. And the air that was coming out of here went up, hit the ceiling, and bounced down right where I stand most of the time. So I made these louvers to direct most of the air to either side. I took the two filter configuration out, and I changed that to hold six filters. The two 14-inch filters was twice the filtration area that I had on my window units, and I was really surprised that it wasn't enough for this. But apparently the pressure drop across the filter was enough for this particular blower, and this blower motor does not appear to be a very good sucker. So by adding four additional filters, I decreased the pressure drop across the total filter area, and now this thing dehumidifies perfectly. I added another latch onto this side. Here. And those filters take advantage of this opening in the corrugations so that we get sufficient airflow. One of these days I'll take it down and paint it.